Dear student, today we are going to learn the prayer, the poem Where the Mind is Without Fear, written by Rabindranath Tagore. Information about the poet. Rabindranath Tagore was born in 1861 and was died in 1941. Was a dramatist, poet, novelist, short story writer, educationist, musical composer and painter. He was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913 for Gitanjali, which is called the Song Offerings. The book contains the English translation by Tagore himself, a poem he had written in Bangla. Tagore contributed to the shaping of the cultural and intellectual identity of modern India. The national anthem of both India and Bangladesh are written by him. The hundreds of songs he composed, Rabindra Sangeet, are still popular. So this is a brief information about the writer Rabindranath Tagore. We all know about him, his composition, and he was first non-European to receive that prize, Nobel Prize for Literature, which he received in 1913. And he also wrote the national anthem of India as well as Bangladesh. Both countries accepted his song as their national anthem. This is the great achievement he has at his credit. So this particular poem about this particular Where the Mind is Without Fear, this is the poem number 35 of Gitanjali, for which he got Nobel Prize. In which this Gitanjali, Where the Mind is Without Fear, is song number 35 of Gitanjali. Where the Mind is Without Fear is a prayer by poet for his country, that it may rise above the narrow notion. Notions means point of view, our way of thinking, narrow notions of the progress. It means that all the countrymen of his country should have broadened attitude towards the progress. They should not be abide by the narrow notions of progress. He prays to God for an atmosphere of freedom and equality based on truth and fearless reasoning. When we will go through this particular poem line by line, we will come to know the real meaning of this statement. It is an expression of poet's reflective spirit and contain his hopes for his country, the India of pre-independence time. But the prayer has a universal message which makes it immortal. So this particular message, this particular poem we have to discuss today. So let us start this particular poem. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into the fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the words come out from the depth of truth, where the tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habits, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. This is very beautiful song. It is actually prayer composed by Rabindranath Tagore to God. He wanted to get his country free from the all shackles of superstition, shackles of dead habits, shackles of bad habits that convention and customs that usually in India the people were used to. So before, if we go through in the history of this particular period, we will come to know that that was the phase of Indian freedom struggle movement. And in that period, before India getting free from the British shackles, he wanted to free his own country from the shackles of dead habits like dead customs, superstitions and bad habits that generally Indian people were consider themselves to follow, and that all habits and superstitions he wanted to remove from the life of Indian people, his countrymen. So where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where he just wants his country like the place where the mind is without fear, the mind of each and every citizen of India should be free from the fear. They should not have any type of fear in their mind, the fear of oppression, the fear of bad habits, the fear of superstition, the fear of bad customs that generally they used to follow. So he wanted his countrymen to be free from all that fear, and that's why that way help them to hold their head high. And that's why he just traces on the point that the mind of each and every individual of Indian people should be free from all the fears of oppression, of the suppression, of the bad habits, of superstition, and that may help them to hold their head high. Where knowledge is free, and how can we get our countrymen free from all this superstition? So because of that, there is only one thing that may free them from their fear, and that is the knowledge. And knowledge should be free, the education should be free, without the hindrance of class, caste, gender or religion. Anybody belonging to any caste, any religion, any gender should be free, should allowed to take education, should be allowed to get more and more knowledge, and only because of that knowledge they can be free from the fear. Where the world has not been broken up into the fragments by narrow domestic walls. So what is this narrow domestic walls? Where the India should be the place where the world has not been broken up into the fragments means, you know very well, the pieces, by the narrow domestic walls. Narrow domestic walls means that the bad habits we generally follow in your life. If we consider the India of that period, there were the customs like child marriages, the bride burning alive with her dead husband, means sati prata, bal viha prata, then casteism, and their untouchability. Such type of bad habits were in existence at that period, and that were the we can say the domestic walls. That domestic walls generally divided the people into the fragment, into the different groups, and that creates such type of operative system in India. And some elite people, the belonging to higher caste, generally used to oppress the people of lower caste, and such type of on the basis of religion there were the practice of untouchability. Such type of bad habits were there, and because of that bad habits the India was divided into the fragment, and that fragment, that domestic walls means that bad habit should be removed. That how fragmented tot India, and that domestic wall should be revealed, where the words come out from the depth of truth. This is also the most important thing. The people in India should be so truthful. Whatever they says, they must say from their bottom of hearts, not manipulating, or not to should not say any word, utter any word to cheat the other people. Whatever they think really, that should be the form, their bottom up hurt, whatever means each and every individual in India should be so truthful that whatever they says should be brought out from their bottom up hurt. And where the tireless striving stretches its arm towards the perfection. India should be the place where the tireless striving stretches means they should be free to do hard work, to do the work whatever they want, whatever they desire in that life, to achieve the perfection in their dream, they should be allowed to do hard work. They should be allowed to do at optimum level, and that may help them to achieve their perfection. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert and dead habits. Where the clear stream of reason, the I want the place, means Rabindranath Tagore wants the place, India, where the mind of each and every individual should be guided by the true reason. There should not be, their mind should not be guided by the superstition, guided by the prejudices they knew at that time. Their mind should be guided by the true reason, what is wrong and what is right, how it is possible and how it is not. Such type of common sense should be used by them to decide anything, and that's why their mind should be guided by the stream of reason, and that reason should not be lost into the dreary desert sand of dead habits. Dreary desert, you know very well, desert, the sand of dead habits. Their dead habits means that habits that was not for the benefits of society, for the civilization, the habits like sati prata, untouchability, like bal vivaha, child marriages, all that. That bad habits were very, we can say, the formidable, the very disastrous, that have the disastrous effect on the society. Because of that bad habits, India was divided into fragmented place. India was divided into various sects and religions and various caste and all that thing. That all the bad habits should be removed from India. And where the mind is laid forward by thee means God. He just prayed to God that where the mind is laid by thee into ever widening thought and action. Ever widening means they should not be guided by the narrow point of view. They should be guided by the broadened point of view, broadened outlook towards the world and towards their life. And that they should be guided by you and into that heaven of freedom. My father is also the consideration for God. Let my country awake, and my country should be awake in the free India, free from the all shackles of dead habits, all shackles of bad habits. My India should be free from the all fear of that, the fear of all type of fears of oppressions and of suppressions and of the untouchability and all. Whatever the bad habits were existence in that time in our India, he just prayed to God that all my countrymen should be free from all that bad habits and prejudices and all that. And may God, my father, let my country awake, and my country should be awake to look into their life, into the world with a positive atmosphere, positive aptitude, and that may lead them to the perfection. So, dear student, this is the very short poem and very beautiful poem, and very clearly he has, generally it is the translation from Bangla to English, and he has simplified the language. That's why there is no any need to annotate this particular poem. And it's like prose-like poem, and I think you might have understood. If you come across any difficulties, please let me know on our group.